Cyrus Fees, MMA Inside the Cage, Fight Now TV. We are here at the Arnold Classic, the 25th anniversary on the final day at the Head Rush booth, talking to Anthony Njokuani. And you got a big fight coming up on UFC on Fox. You got to be looking forward to that, man. I know you're coming off the loss to Dos Anjos, so you're ready to get back on the winning track.
Yeah, it's been a long layoff. I'm ready to get back in there. I've been out of the game for like 6 months. So, yeah, man, I'm hungry. I'm ready to get in there and do work and, you know, and have a great fight for my fans.
That has to be hard, being like on a 6 month layoff. I know that kind of happens time to time, yeah. But when that happens, you feel like maybe you kind of get that rust, that sort of thing, when you get back actually into the cage for the UFC.
Actually, not, because during the whole time when I did have the 6 month layoff, I was in the gym working. Even though I couldn't use my right hand, you know, see this bad boy right there?
Yeah.
That's where it was all like healed up. And, yeah. So now it's like extra bone built on top of bone. So, I mean, it's a lot stronger now. It's 10 times harder, and the impact's going to be a lot worse. So,
You got Robbie Bowling, a guy that has, you know, made his name in Strikeforce. He's had a lot of big fights in Strikeforce, a lot of big wins. What are you looking for out of this fight, man? How are you preparing for Roger Bowen and what he brings to the table?
Really, I just brought in a lot of wrestlers from Ohio, yeah. Missouri. I've been working a lot on my jiu-jitsu. He's a tough kid. He's a wild kid. He's one of those wild punchers, wide and all sides type style punch. Been just focusing on my Muay Thai, getting that down. It's been a really tough camp, because I put a lot into this camp because I wanted to come out and just make a big splash especially for the new year. So
yeah,
and especially coming out and finally getting my hand healed, I just want to go out there and do my best and give the fans a good fight.
Now you made that transition from I'm sure hungry. Obviously, Roger Bowen in Strikeforce wants to prove something by making his name in the UFC. And, what can you say about that? Kind of, what was going through your head when you jumped WEC in the UFC? Kind of feel for.
Oh yeah, I mean, I know he's gonna come out there hard like an animal. I know he's gonna come out there like a gorilla. So I know he's gonna try to take my head out, because he was in my shoes, where he's at, is where I used to be at. And I know he's gonna try to come in there and try to get a big win on his belt, especially with a veteran of UFC. But it's not gonna happen, because I've been in the game for a very long time. If he tries to come at me hard, I'm gonna try to come at him even harder.
Think of the lightweight title situation going on right now. Of course, Benson's still holding the title right now. Anthony Pettis kind of in the hunt as well. What do you think of the whole title situation? Because obviously, that still has to be the goal. I mean, you said you've been in the game for a while. You have, but you're still fairly young in your career. I mean, you're still like in your prime right now. So you have to be really wanting to make a title run, stringing those victories together. What can you talk about that?
Well, right now, I'm just trying to focus on myself. You know, I don't want to focus on whatever else anybody else is doing. I just want to win these three fights that I have and hopefully get a title shot. And, you know, Ben is my boy, but if he still has a belt during that time, I have to come for it.
What do you think of Anthony Pettis and the rise that he's had?
Anthony Pettis is doing real good. He's one of my homies, too. You know, can't talk bad about the kid. I love the kid. He's a great dude. But what he's doing right now is smart. If he wants to go down and challenge somebody else for the belt, which is good. I know he can do it. He has a talent. And, just keep on doing what he's doing.
Absolutely. Your brother, GD, doing work in RFA, getting ready for his big fight in Denver. How well do you guys work together? I mean, is that something that just nonstop, you guys always work out together? Or do you do separate camps, go different places? How's that work?
Nah, my brother's always going to be by my side. That's my little brother, you know. I'm the one that actually brought him into the game.
Yeah.
You know, I'm always going to be by his side, give him, like, pointers on what he needs to do and what he doesn't need to do. And right now he's doing very well. He's on a 7-fight win streak. I'm talking about he's mowing through everybody right now. And I know for a fact this guy that he's about to fight now in Denver, he's going to mow through that guy and then get into either UFC or whoever picks him up. But every single time, like, whatever training that I do, he's doing it with me. He sticks to my hip like glue, so we're inseparable.
So he's on a rise right now, man. 7-5 win streak. He may very well get into the UFC at some point. Is there that competitive edge? You always kind of want to have that edge above your brother. I know we talked in our last interview that you guys were real cool together and stuff. It wasn't all that competitive, but you don't really want him creeping by you. You know what I mean?
Not really. Come on, this is my brother. If my brother creeps by me, he creeps by me. You know, I'm not going to, like, be that type of person. Like, forget you, dog. I don't like you, man.
Like the the movie. You know, that was real realistic. And then we get Jamie and Anthony in there, you know.
See, that movie Warrior is brothers that don't like each other. That's what it is. Yeah. See, me and my brother, he respects me. He loves me just the same way I respect and love him. We will never, like, nobody in our family ever comes at each other like that. We're all really tight.
Yeah.
And there will never be a time where he'll, like, run into the room, kick me in my head because I beat him and I beat him in this, like, running down the street or whatever, you know,
yeah.
or sprinting. That would never happen in the Njokuani family because we're all, like, really tight. All my sisters, we all talk to each other. We're really close. If I have something on my mind that I need to talk to them about, I'll go to them talk. Just like the same thing with my brother. No, we're never competitive. We're never like that. We're all... Hey, look, it's the Terminator. That's my guy.
He's a big dude, man. What do you think of some of these bodybuilders, these monsters walking around here?
It's very scary, especially the women. I'm a fighter, but I'm fighting at 155. I'm intimidated by these little fuckers around here. It is crazy. The women, I don't think I'll ever try to walk up to a Tato, because if I do, somebody's going to shoot, one of them's going to snap me in half. No, not happening here. I will stay away. But yeah, but I mean, it's fun though. It's fun. Especially the sexy ones, man. This, woo, the fitness. Look at that one. Yeah, buddy.
They are wiling out here at the Head Rush booth here at the Arnold Classic. Anthony Njokuani, he's getting ready for Roger Bowling, Cyrus Fees, MMA Inside the Cage, and Fight Now TV.